Are you preparing for an exam or reading something and you are highlighting the main points and rereading it again and again in the hope that you will remember it more? The only problem with that approach is researchers have proved that rereading is a waste of time. Instead, you should be doing spaced repetition or active recall. In this video, you will learn why you should never reread any material and why you should be doing active recall or spaced repetition based on the forgetting curve. And I'm going to show you how to design an active recall system or spaced repetition using Leitner system or flashcards to help you remember more. In the 19th century, psychologist Hermann Ebbinghaus produced a graph called forgetting curve that indicates how much information you will retain after a certain period of time. If you learn any new information, you quickly forget it and retain only a fraction of the original material. This was not a new finding, but the implications of this curve was. It indicates that if you are trying to learn something, you should space out your learning sessions and perform active recall or spaced repetition. Let's say, if you have 10 hours to prepare for an exam, instead of reading the whole material one night before the exam, divide it into 1 hour session for 10 days. You invest the same amount of time, but you will retain the information for a longer period of time. Our brain is composed of billions of neurons. When you are experiencing anything new, your neurons are firing together. These neurons that are firing together creates a connection and forms a memory. When you recollect the same information in the future, these neurons are again fired together, giving you the particular memory. The connections that are not frequently fired together lost their connection and the memory is lost. But here is a catch. Researchers have found out that frequent rereading won't do much help in terms of strengthening the connections of the neurons. If you have to memorize something, you should be doing something called spaced repetition or active recall. What it means is that you should not be rereading the same material again and again. Instead, after a certain interval of time, you should be recalling the information from the memory. This interval should not be too long that you have to relearn the whole material and not too short that you will remember it without any effort. The interval should be designed in such a way that the information will come to you after little probing inside your memory. One technique that you can use to design the interval is the Leitner system. In this system, you have to use the help of flashcards. Write down the information on one side of the card and the keys or cues on the other side of the card. Make a groupings of the cards. The groupings of the card will indicate how often you have to revise the material. For example, you can set the groupings as daily, once a week, once a month, once every 3 months, once every 6 months, and so on. As soon as you design a specific card, you put it in the daily grouping. Then you revise it the next day. If you find that the information is coming back to you easily, you move the card to once a week grouping. Then you revise it again after 1 week. If the information is readily available to you, move the card to once a month grouping and revise it after 1 month. You continue this process until the information is permanently moved into your long-term memory, and by that time, you may not need to revise it again. But in any of the revision, if you find that you can't recollect the information even after much effort, then you move the card to the first grouping of the daily cards and you repeat the whole process again. This process will transfer the information into your long-term memory. As a bonus for sticking till the end, I'm showing two very simple techniques that you can use right now to design the intervals. The first one is the use of some software. There are many free softwares that can design the interval for you. The most popular one is the software Anki, and it's free. I personally use Anki. I've created a separate video on how to use Anki, and I'll give the link to that video in the description. Another simple method that you can use is a Fibonacci repetition. Here is a Fibonacci sequence. In this sequence, you get the subsequent numbers by adding the just preceding two numbers. That is, you get 13 by adding 8 and 5. You get 21 by adding 13 and 8, and so on. You can use this sequence to make the spaced repetition. Revise your material just after learning, again after some time on the same day, the next revision on the next day, the fourth revision on the third day, fifth on the fifth day, and so on. One thing you can note here, there is no hard and fast rule to design your spaced repetition. Test out yourself and make changes based on your needs and experiences. Hi, this is Suraj Laurembam, and I'm your instructor at Hyper Quick Friend. As a congratulation gift for learning something today, I put a link in the description and a pinned comment where you will get a free booklet educating you on the three enemies of speed reading and how to counter them using a free online tool that I have designed. Don't miss this opportunity and click on the link now.